We all have our reasons to visit this little slice of paradise in India. I don't know what yours is, but we find ourselves in Goa at least thrice in a year to spend quality time with our family, nature, and of course, to make up for the fresh seafood that we lose out so much on in Pune.
What is up, guys? I am Gavin.
I'm Adrian.
And guess what, guys? We have a surprise in today's video.
I'm Rosie.
I'm Rufina.
And we are in
Goa!
So it's been a long time since we've gone out for a drive, and our pilot today here is Madin. Hi Madin.
Hi.
And our expert chef in the back seat, that is Mama.
Hi.
And you have all met her, that is Adrian.
Hi.
In today's vlog, we will drive for nearly 5 kilometers from Casa de Rosa in Kalangut to Pinto's Vado in Kandulim. As most of you might already know, Kalangut is located in the North Goa region, and it is a pretty wild place to party. Over the years, Kalangut has become the go-to place for many Indian tourists. Each one has their own opinion about Kalangut, but if you are a party animal by night and a wanderer by day, this place might just be ideal for you. If you ever plan to visit North Goa, in terms of accommodation, we have the perfect recommendation for you guys. Casa de Rosa is located in Khobrowado, Kalangut. They have spacious rooms plus the basic amenities like an AC, fridge and TV. What I love the most are these huge balconies in each room with this picturesque view and tranquil surroundings. And the best part, it's just a 5 to 10 minutes walk to the beach between Baga and Kalangut. I'll leave the contact number of Casa de Rosa and a link of the video which has complete details of this homestay that's run by Adrian's family.
So after a 15 minutes drive and a lot of chit-chatting, we have made it to Kandulim.
I love Kandulim so much. What's changed over the years is that the roads are super clean, and during season time you'll see a lot of international tourists flocking to Kandulim every year. They have a gorgeous beach as well, and many of us watching have probably had some absolutely amazing memories of this place. I miss my friends a lot. We have never ever had a bad trip in Goa. And also, one of the many benefits of visiting Goa is the fresh seafood. And what can be better than fresh seafood with a lot of authentic Goan flavors? We've made it to Vishal's in Pinto Vado, and it has a typical ambience that you can expect at a seaside restaurant in Goa. What I like the most is, even though it's hot outside, once you step at Vishal's, it's airy, and the tantalizing fragrances coming out of the kitchen will tell your brains to forget everything and just think about the array of seafood delicacies that are in store.
So guys, as you can see, we are super excited to be back here in Goa, and I have the menu right here in front of me. So I will let you know what kind of food items you can expect once you're here. A very short and sweet menu, guys. So here are all the thalis: mackerel thali, special thali, kingfish thali, prawns, special prawns thali, morso and sonak. And apart from that, here you have all the contact details. And if you flip over, you will get to see some other non-veg delicacies of Goa as well. So raw omelette, you know, is very famous. Shakuti, and then chili fry, kafriyal. These items are very, very synonymous to Goan food. And apart from that, you see the other starters here, guys. We have gone through the menu and we will have a short discussion and let you guys know what we have decided to order. So stay tuned and keep watching the video right until the end. So guys, guys, I wanted to speak to Vishal outside, but he is a very, very busy man. And I asked Vishal, like, since how long you're operating this place? So you are here since 1 year. And prior to this,
in June
you'll complete 1 year. Okay. And prior to this, he was operating this out of his residence in Kandolim, and that time he's been working since 27 years, right?
On my restaurant, 27.
Your restaurant, yeah. And he started working since the age of 16, guys. So if you want to know Goans and how hard Goans work, this is a true example, because I know that very well. My mother-in-law was a chef who's sitting outside. She was in Bahrain chef for 35 years. And there was a time she used to work like 16-17 hours in the kitchen.
My dad started working at the age of 8.
At the age of 8.
Yes.
So guys, now you know why the food is so tasty here. Because Vishal himself ensures the food is done. And behind every successful man is a successful woman. And the woman is here. She is Mrs. Nisha, Vishal's wife. And look at this guy. She is washing the huge tiger prawns. And this is their kitchen, and this is their entire crew. So guys,
this is the
hard working one. Okay, so there is another gentleman here who is Captain Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Vishal's Virat Kohli. So he is the one, guys, who is behind the scenes. He's always with us. That's nice. That's really nice to know you have a helping hand, because it's not easy here, guys. In the month of May, very hot here, but guys, the food here is fabulous, and credit goes to these guys. I had to come in the kitchen and show you what's happening behind the scenes. So guys, here is Master Chef, and here is our entire family. They have a feast that is going to happen here. That's it there. So Vishal, quickly, this is the
prawn curry, bhindi, bhaji, kismur, then tisrio, and kheer, salad.
Correct.
Yeah, right.
And we watch this sizzling
in
the pan.
Because that today is made of small fish.
Ah,
so
no problem.
Comes a big one.
No problem. So yeah. Guys, fish is seasonal. It totally depends upon the catch. Okay. And this is mackerel. We saw that in the kitchen. It was sizzling away on the pan. And Mrs. Nisha was the one cooking. So guys, Vishal has to rush. I will let him go. Thank you. I'm going to start off with this onion bhajia. So long time, guys. This reminds me of Mumbai. Onion bhajia is flavorful. I can instantly taste the crunchiness of the onion and the flour that's been used. Very tasty, guys, and look at everyone here. All of this is just disappearing in their plates. So today I'm not going to review the food completely. I'm going to ask the masters here, because they are the ones who cook this day in and day out. So Madin, how are the crabs, the tisrio and the fish?
Very tasty.
Yes. What about the masalas?
The masalas are genuine
Goan masala. That's nice. And guys, Adrian here is a big fan of crabs. I don't like crabs. So look at the size of this crab, guys. So Adrian, what was different about this crab?
The masalas are authentic
yes.
Rechado masala.
Rechado masalas.
And the piece is, and the crab is full of meat. As you can see.
That's right. As you can see inside, guys, it is loaded with meat.
Yeah.
And these are the tisrios. Adrian, could you please taste the tisrios?
Lovely here. Masala mixture he's
you
done.
You already had it. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, nice. And you can see the meat in the tisrios. And I have Mama here again, who is eating the same thing. How is the bangda?
Bangda is very good.
Nice. And is it like crispy rava fried?
It's crispy rava fried.
Is it fresh?
Yes.
That's really lovely.
Clams.
So the fish is fresh as well, and clams, yeah.
The clams are also very good.
Very nice clams.
Garlic prawns.
And look at this, guys. Meanwhile, Adrian has broken the shell, and look at the white meat inside. Okay. And Madin has already tasted a bit of the thali. Oh, sorry, butter garlic crab prawns. How is this? Brilliant. That's nice. So guys, if you have a look, while we were eating, there are some customers that have come here to eat as well. And this is a very local place which is inside the by lanes of Kandolim. Not a lot of people know this place. So if you are in Goa, I highly recommend this place to you guys.
Food is very nice.
So guys, here I have Madin who is having the kismur.
It's done very nicely.
Very nicely, okay. But it looks a bit different. Is it a bit different to the regular kismur?
Yes. Yes.
It is a bit. I think there are more of onion. It's more has more of onion and coconut.
And it's not dried.
Not very
dried kismur.
Okay. And as we speak, here comes some more prawn curry.
Yes.
And some more rice, guys. So we love the food so much. Obviously, this much wasn't enough. We had to get some more. Okay, Madin, what's next? Taste the curry.
The prawn curry is very nice.
You can put a little bit on the rice and try. No? I know it's a lot. I am giving a bit of trouble to Madin, but guys, these guys are the ones who
nice
cook this
done.
Day in and day out. Yes,
he's saying it's very nice.
Okay. So rest of the things you've tasted. Could you please taste that chapati and the bende? Okay, bhende.
Bhende is nice.
You try this one.
Nice, very nice.
Okay, guys. So that was a complete tour of all the food that we have on the table. Okay, there's one thing that's missing. You didn't taste the chornak. Could you please taste the chornak?
Tell her to taste.
Adrian, taste the chornak. Madin is full. Quickly. Squeeze a bit of lime if you want. So yes, finger licking good, and as you just saw, Adrian licked all her fingers. Okay, and she is now squeezing the lime over the chornak. Look at the size of the chornak, guys. So the size totally depends upon the time of the year you're coming. And look at all the meat, guys. This is so good. Okay. This is the ultimate. Nice.
Damn good.
Wow, that was a very, very strong expression that Adrian has given. I have to try the chornak now because I also, Adrian couldn't break a piece because I have the mic with me.
Damn
yeah,
good.
Put this on.
The crabs are full. The food is so delicious.
My mother-in-law wants to say something.
The food is so delicious, it's out of the world.
As I said, it's a very local place in Goa. We all know the big names in Goa, but not a lot of people know these small places. And take it from these guys, they live in Goa, they know Goan food flavors, and these are authentic Goan flavors that you can get in Goa, guys. So if you are in Goa, make sure you drop by here at Vishal's Goan Food Restaurant in Kandolim. So guys, I have the entire crew here of Vishal's Goan Seafood Restaurant, and I must tell you that these guys are doing a fantastic job in Goa. Trust me, this is one of the best seafood I've ever had in Goa. So thank you so much, guys. And if you are in Goa, make sure you come and visit these guys because they will never let you down. Thank you.